Hey there, my name's Logan, and I'm a technical instructor here at DBT Labs. This video is going to focus on supporting DBT Cloud admins setting up their environments inside of cloud, keeping in mind that we're focusing specifically on folks who are using Databricks. When you log in to DBT Cloud, this is your welcome page. Right now, it's not too exciting, and this is what we're working towards building up so that we have a greater dashboard when we come into the product. We've done a little bit of work so far inside of the Develop tab, but for this video, we're going to turn our attention to Deploy. If you click this Deploy dropdown, you'll see a couple different options, and we're going to go directly into Environments. Now, in Environments, you'll see that you already have an environment built. This environment is our development environment, which is powering the Develop tab. This is something that will be unique to each person. They're inputting their own credentials, and it's going to work a little bit differently than any other environment that we create. Before we get into environment creation, I do want to point out that this video is focusing specifically on a direct promotion strategy for our branches, meaning that folks are branching off of and merging into the main branch every single time. We're not going to go into the different strategies, and we're not really going to spend time doing CI/CD today, but keep in mind that those are options. And if you're looking to employ something like that inside of your DBT project, I would point you to our docs.getdbt.com webpage. So let's get into it. The first thing we're going to want to do to create an environment is click this button, Create Environment. Now, environment creation is fairly straightforward and user-friendly. There's going to be three segments that we're going to have to complete. The first one is our general settings, which is where we're going to name our environment. Here, I'm going to name it production so that it's very clear what this environment is serving to do. It is creating our production data. Secondly, there's an option for environment type, which you'll notice I can't actually change. We can only have two types of environments inside of DBT Cloud, a development environment and a deployment environment. We already have one development environment, which is the max. So every other environment we create is going to be categorized as a deployment. There is an option for DBT version. Typically, we would recommend you just letting it default to the version that's there. But if you ever wanted to play around with something, maybe get into the pre-release for the next patch to make sure things are working, this is where you would do that. The final option in our general settings is only run on a custom branch. Now, I told you that we're not going to get into CI/CD, but if that's something that interests you, this is where you're going to be looking. Only run on a custom branch allows us to indicate a branch other than main where this environment is going to be grabbing code. Again, we're not going to dive into this now, so I'm going to leave this unchecked. As we move down to deployment connection, this I think is the easiest option for setting up. There's going to be lots of default information in here. You'll see the server hostname is being grabbed from our development environment and what we've already input, same as the HTTP path. The only option we have here is to indicate a catalog into which we want our production data being built. If you leave it default, just like in development, it's going to kick off to the Hive Meta Store, but I would like it to live in its own catalog, which we're going to call prod. Once I have this indicated, then I'm going to move down to my final section, which are my deployment credentials. Here, I'm going to be entering the deployment credentials for the service principal that I created inside of Databricks, okay? You're gonna go to your service principal inside of Databricks, grab that token and drop it here. This is going to allow this environment to access Databricks via the service principal and create different schemas, create different tables and views that exist inside of your DBT Cloud environment and build them for production in Databricks. Finally, we're going to indicate a schema here that we wanted to build to. I'm going to name that schema Analytics. So really, inside of environment creation, there are only a couple things we have to do. First, we have to name it. Then we have to choose the catalog and the schema to which we want our production data built. And we're going to input the service principal token here. Once all that's done, I'm going to click Save. And voila, my environment is created. Now I can start getting into jobs, build out jobs, execute code on a schedule inside of DBT Cloud, and really get the most out of my experience. Thanks so much.